The first plugin we're going to discuss is called Animated Text, which adds a new behavior to Construct 3. This behavior lets us quickly animate text to one of 5 different styles, and it also gives us some events that we can use in the event sheet. The Animated Text behavior is made by a developer named Toby R, and you can find this plugin in the Sierra store, which I'll include a link to in the description. This plugin works in both Construct 2 and Construct 3, but we'll be using it in Construct 3 today. I've got a new project set up here with one layout, with just a light blue background. I'm going to add some text to this, letting the player know they've lost the game and encouraging them to play again. But we'll use the Animated Text behavior to make the text look a little less generic and add some movement to our game over screen. The first thing we need to do is add a text object to the layout. Double-click and choose Text under the General category. I'll name this text object Gameovertext. We need some room for our text to animate, so I'll stretch out the Gameovertext object to fill most of the width of the layout. And I'll make it a little taller, too. I'll delete the text value and just leave it blank. When using this behavior, don't set the text here. You'll want to set the text in the event sheet to properly trigger the animation. Also, underneath text, I'll change the font, too. Feel free to choose whatever you'd like, but I'll choose Century Gothic. Then I'll set the size of the font up a bit, to 26. Now let's add the Animate Text behavior to the Game Over Text object. Click on Behaviors and select Add New. Once installed, the Animated Text behavior is listed under the General category. Go ahead and add it to the GameOverText object. Once the behavior is added to the object, we have 3 properties we can adjust: Animation Mode, Animation Time, and Time Mode. All 3 are easy to use, but we need some text in our object to animate before we can discuss them. So let's switch over to the event sheet. We'll add a new event using the System object. We'll start this event when the layout is loaded. So let's use OnStartOfLayout under the Start and End category. Add an action, this time using the GameOverText object. If I scroll down a bit, you can see all the actions the Animated Text behavior allows us to use. We can set Animation Mode or Animation Time, set the text, force the animation to finish, or stop the animation. For now, we want to set the text, so I'll choose Set Text. Under Text, I'll enter Game Over. Try again. Setting the text with this action will trigger the animation to begin. At this point, we can preview the layout. And the text animates as if it was being typed from left to right. But it's moving too slow. Under the Animated Text Behaviors properties, we can change Animation Time to 1, which will speed it up. The Animation Time affects the length of the animation, depending on the setting of Time Mode. Right now, Time Mode is set to full animation. That means whatever value we have in Animation Time, that's how long in seconds it will take for the full animation to complete. Since we have it set to 1, that means it will take 1 second for the entire game over string to be typed to the layout. The other option for time mode is per character, which causes animation time to determine the length of time each character is displayed for before the next character is revealed. So currently, it would take 1 second between each letter appearing on the screen. For now, I'll set time mode to full animation and animation time to 1 second. If we preview it, it looks a lot better. Now, let's take a look at the animation modes. We've got 5 options available, each of which changes the way the animation affects the text. Each of these modes are also affected by the way text is horizontally aligned, too. Let's take a look at what I mean. Right now, we're using the typing left mode, which causes the text to be typed to the screen from left to right. If we change the horizontal alignment to right, the text is revealed character by character, with each new character pushing the others to the left. Next, we've got the typing right mode, which does the opposite of typing left. It reveals the characters from right to left, starting with the end of the text first. This is what typing right looks like when horizontally aligned to the right. And this is what it looks like when aligned to the left. Then, we've got typing center mode. This looks best if you set the horizontal alignment to center as well. To really show how this mode works, I'll change the text of our Game Over text object to DCBA ABCD. The typing center mode reveals the text from the center of the string outwards, two characters at a time. The first step will reveal the two A's, then the two B's, and so on. Let's take a look. As you can see, it reveals two characters at a time from the center of the string outwards. After that, we have the typing sides mode, which behaves exactly the opposite of the typing center mode. This mode reveals the text two characters at a time, starting with the outermost characters in the string, in this case, the two D's, then reveals inwards towards the center. Take a look. This mode also tends to look the best while using center horizontal alignment. Last, we have the random mode, which will reveal one character at a time selected randomly from the entire string. This mode will look slightly different each time the layout is run, since it will reveal each character in a random order. Let's set the mode back to typing left. And set the alignment to left. Now, let's take a look at the events and actions we can use. I'll change the text to "Thanks for playing." Let's add a new event using the Game Over text object. Under Animated Text General, you can see all of the conditions the animated text behavior gives us access to. We've got the isAnimating event, the onAnimationFinished event, and the onAnimationStarted event. isAnimating will fire off if the animation is currently active, and it will stop if it has completed. onAnimationStart and onAnimationFinish are self-explanatory. They fire off when the animation starts and when it finishes. Those are easy enough, so let's move on to the actions available to the behavior. Click on Add Action and choose the Game Over text object. We talked about animation mode and animation time, both of which can be set here in the event sheet using Set Animation Mode and Set Animation Time. And we've already used Set Text. That leaves us with two more options, Force Finish and Stop. Let's take a look at what each of these do. What Force Finish is used for is to force the object to go to the end of the animation. Let's say we don't want a 5-second animation to play, and after 2 seconds pass, we want the entire string to be displayed. I'll add the Force Finish action. Let's set the animation time to 5 seconds. And I'll add another action using the System object. I'll choose the Wait action. And we'll wait for 2 seconds. Drag the wait action in between the set text action and the force finish action. If I preview, the animation plays as it should for 2 seconds, then it's forced to finish, jumping to the end of the animation. Stop is very similar, except it doesn't jump to the end of the animation. It stops the animation at whatever position it's currently in. If I change force finish to stop and preview the layout, the animation plays for 2 seconds and stops, only displaying thanks. That covers the animated text behavior and how it can be used. The ability to quickly animate text like this can add a lot visually to your game, and this behavior saves quite a bit of time as long as you understand how to use it. Thanks for watching. If you find this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. at patreon.com/todaystuts. For $1 a month, you'll get early access to all new videos, and you'll help keep this channel alive. See you next time.